So talk about how it feels to start 1-0 against a really good program in the OK Red in East Kentwood.
Man, you never know what you're going to get week one. You know what I mean? Scrimmages, you don't see a whole lot. They did some things tonight that they didn't do in the scrimmage, which, you know, I'm sure we did things that we didn't do in the scrimmage. So but they've got some really good athletes. They got some really good football players. They're well coached. I'm just excited. Our kids just wowed me tonight with the way they played, the way they came out here for pregame. It was hotter than heck. And I'm thinking, man, we're going to have to do a lot to keep these guys cheered up and excited about being out here. And it was like, I haven't seen a team do that in a few years with the excitement and the passion to be out here. And you could just tell they were happy to be out here. And it showed in the first few series where we were just flying around creating and making plays.
With such a young team this year, talk about how Miles' experience really helps this team and helps it develop over the course.
I mean, the kids have been watching him. These sophomores that are on the varsity right now were in, you know, seventh grade when he, you know, or sixth grade when he was a freshman playing in a state championship game. So they really have a lot of, you know, I mean, at the time in sixth, seventh, eighth grade, who do you want to be? I want to be Miles Walton. Well, now all those kids that admired him are now his teammates, and he's doing a heck of a job leading them, inspiring them. Had a great week of practice. And those kids believe in him, which brings the best out of them, and it elevated their game.
Talk about what contributed to your guys' fast start.
I think it was just the energy. I think it was the energy and the excitement of playing high school football. I mean, on Friday night, no COVID, no masks, and I think it was just that we just got off to a good start playing physical and fast and overcoming any of the little mistakes that if we'd have felt sorry for ourselves could have hurt us later on down the road. So I believe it was just their energy.
Next week, you guys got a big one at home against Cass Tech. Talk about what it'll take to try and win that one.
You know, we got to be in shape. We got to just try to keep, you know, they're a team of big playmakers. It's going to be ball control. They're physical and big on defense. You know, I get to go see them tomorrow. So it's going to be, we're going to have to hang on to the football. We're going to have to try to, you know, just out scheme them a little bit. But they have some dudes and they can play. And I tell you what, that's a win-win for either one of us. I mean, Cass or Muskegon. You play a caliber of that game week two, I mean, you're only going to come out of that better no matter what happens. And I'm excited as heck to be a part of that game. I'm going to enjoy this for the rest of the day, but man, am I excited about it being televised live. All the hype and the videos and all that stuff is being made by Bailey's TV, the Fox Sports Detroit Network partner there. And I'm just excited for that game to happen at Hackney Stadium. So man, I'm going to, like I said, I want to say, let's buckle up and let's go. Well, let me enjoy this one for a little bit, and then I'll see you on Monday.
Thank you, Coach. Congrats.
Appreciate all you do, Mike. Thank you.